What's going on, YouTube? It's Twig.
And Buddy.
We're back bringing you guys another episode in the Dark Souls 2 walkthrough. And just real quick, I'm going to go get one or two items that I missed on the way in.
Did you get the 5 homeward bones as well? From the top of the path by the Champion's Way or whatever it's called?
Oh yeah, the Covenant of Champions. I went and got that, but you did point out that I missed the... If you jump off this ledge right here, everybody probably knows it since the game's been out a while, but if you didn't know it, you can get the a couple good things right there. Binoculars come in handy too. So now I think we might have everything.
I gotta turn in 2 shards. I just got the one from the whale. And I'm gonna go up and get the Titanite shards from the guy's shop.
So you got the one from the well, and then you have the one she gives you?
Yeah.
Alright, so let me go ahead and put those on my hotbar, because we're going to need those. And then go ahead and put the homeward bones on there. So, with that, are you ready to go to Force of the Fallen Giants?
Yeah, right after I turn these in. I just got to.
Alright, sweet. Now... What I plan on doing through this, or on our way to Force of the Fallen Giants, let me get this chest. I think it's just a rusted coin, right? Or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, rusted coin. So, what I plan on doing is, there are a couple good items up here, and I'll get the ones where you jump off the bridge, but I'm probably going to run past all the enemies just because I don't feel like fighting them. Like, you know how I do, right?
Yeah.
Let me go ahead and take this stuff off.
I think I may try to kill as many as I can just so I have more souls at the beginning of the game.
Alright. Couple human effigies. Another homeward bone and some more souls. Now, I'll run past these guys and get this bonfire. They should continue to follow me and attack me even though I light the bonfire, but shouldn't be a big deal. Now, I did forget to go back and get the pine resins at the very beginning by the troll.
Oh, you didn't do that?
No, I didn't do it, but I will go back, and we'll go back to... we'll go back that way and get the... knock down the ladder and do all that cool stuff for the smooth and silky guys.
Yeah.
Oh man, I can't believe I got hit right there. But we'll go back and do that when we get our second Fragrant Bench of Yore. So that we can go and get the Estus Flask shard. Now, what you're wanting to do, if you're wanting to do this like I'm doing it, is you can't be greedy. Because I found that if you're greedy, you're probably going to die through here. I will be kind of greedy right here, though. And go ahead and pick up this life gem. Oh, there we go. And then you're going to want to sprint past this guy right here. He'll pull out his sword, and he may knock me down. But no, he didn't. Thank goodness. Now they're going to be following us, and there's going to be a guy coming around this corner right there to my left. I'll run in and get the bonfire though real quick, and I may have to kill this guy. Oh my gosh, alright. What was up top that was really important?
Well, it was blue bugs that you could kill.
Oh, true that.
Right, and then I think an axe that was really good for the beginning.
Ooh, yeah. It is actually pretty freaking good. I don't really want to fight those guys. Oh, you can get that blue bug, which is really good. Alright, there we go. Can't remember what these items are. Up top. think there's a chest. Yes, there is a chest. So we'll get these. Oh, I didn't start the timer, so I don't know what we're...
We're just 5 minutes in.
5 minutes in. Alright, let me get this chest real quick. Alright, now if I don't screw this up, I hopefully won't die right here. Because I've fallen off this before and died. Alright. So let's go ahead and take a rest right here. Go back down and get that item over here after we kill this guy. Okay. Marking some stuff off our checklist. I'll pop a couple souls and real quick. Alright, let's see. Now, if you guys didn't know, you want to exhaust all of the Merchant Hag Lady's dialogue so that she'll go back to Majula. So that you can buy infinite life gems. Alright, so there we go. I'm going to buy one firebomb from her. Now we're going to want to buy this key, and we're going to want to buy the Fragrant Branch of Yore. Eventually, but for right now, just one firebomb will do. And I'll go ahead and head down there. Alright, where are you, Eddie?
I'm just about to go through the fog gate, so you're just a little bit ahead of me.
Alright. And the reason you'll see in just a second why we actually wanted to, actually, let me put that on. And this is gonna follow me. I needed to put it on my, hotbar. Real quick. Oh, we had a firebomb already. Now you can get that guy up there to throw it, and throw the firebomb and blow up the door. But sometimes he ends up either or doesn't actually blow up the wall, right? So I just do it myself. And it's always nice to have extra firebombs. But while you're doing that, I'm just gonna run and do the loop real quick and open up the door. The roll right there, and I think you can actually just fall right here and not take too much damage. But yes, so I want them to throw their firebombs and kill these guys if at all possible. No, doesn't look like it's gonna happen. Screw it. Alright. Aggro these guys. And get them away from the fog wall. Or the fog gate over here. Oh no, hope that doesn't end up. And we're basically making a little loop right here so that we can safely go down to the last giant. A lot quicker way as well. Okay then, we got that. Thinking about what else I can do real quick. What time are we at right now?
9 minutes, 45 seconds.
Alright, so we're not looking too bad.
I just got the witching urns, I'm about to go in the door. The merchant hag. Did you already do the hole in the wall?
Yes, I did. You don't really have to worry about gathering too many souls, E. If you... Oh, no. Forgot that, Alright. I forgot that he comes back up. But, you don't really have to worry about getting too many souls. Since that we're basically killing, like... We're gonna kill the Pursuer twice right here at the beginning. We're gonna kill the Last Giant, and we're gonna kill Dragon Rider pretty fast into the game. So, let me go ahead and pop the soul I just got. That should get us almost a 2K. What can we buy from her? We can buy the key. So that is very nice. Very nice. Now, I'm going to go ahead and buy it. And I'm going to make... I'll go ahead and go get the flame sword down there. Do you want me to sit at the bonfire and wait for you? So, and then we'll just cut the video.
Yeah, sure, that'll be.
So that way I don't get too far in front of you.
Yeah. All right.
All right, guys. So I'll sit just like this, and we'll cut the video and bring it back in as soon as me and Buddy get caught up with each other. All right, guys. So we're caught up now. And let me see, I was thinking while E was going through the Forest of the Fallen Giants, I was thinking I could use the axe right now and go ahead and use this to kill the Last Giant to get some souls before I buy the rapier and upgrade it as much as possible. So what I want to do is go back to Majula, open up Linagrass shop, and I believe he has a bow in his chest, right?
Yeah, he has a bow, and then Yeah, and after you open it, you can actually just sit at the bonfire. You don't have to travel anywhere.
Alright, sounds good. So,
I may be able to buy the rapier.
Yeah, so he has a bow. I opened up his doors. Alright. Yeah, what does the rapier do compared to the axe? I can't remember checking it at the beginning of the game. Like, on my soul level 1 character, I'm pretty sure I used this axe and just upgraded and used this all the way through. Alright, so... Can't buy anything yet, but that's the weapon I'm going to be buying. I need 12 dex, but I'll be getting some souls through the Last Giant. And also, are you traveling back there, or are you still looking?
Yeah, I'm traveling back now.
Me as well. E brought up a good point while we were sitting there talking, and he said he reminded me that you can't kill the Pursuer here. Actually, I don't think I showed you guys where he spawns yet, but if you go out this door right here, he spawns up on that platform up there. There's a ladder right over there that you go up, and that there's an Estus flask up there, isn't there? Or did they move that?
Oh, no, yeah, it's up there.
It's still up there?
Yeah.
It's in that corner where he's standing, too, isn't it? Or it's on the side somewhere, but it's up there. And if you kill him, he'll fly down, and the bird will drop him right there. And if you kill him on your first... He only appears for your first meeting, right?
Yeah.
And if you kill him while he's up there, you won't have to face him later. But I don't really want to kill him right there because it's kind of like...
It's easier to kill him... With the crossbow.
Yeah, it's easier to kill him with the crossbow, and I don't think people normally would kill him right there, you know?
Yeah. I wish you could kill him there and in the... That'd be sick.
Yeah, that would be sick.
Alright, so are you ready to go in the Last Giant?
Yeah, just a second. I got the Estus Flash Shard. There's a couple more items up here. Prepare powder would come in handy, but see... He spawns up here, and if you kill him, he doesn't respawn, so for the later fight as well, but we'll probably get to that in the next episode. I'll set up the bonfire real quick, regen my health, and we'll go down and kill the Last Giant real quick and get the soldier's key. Now, when you kill him, he'll drop the soldier's key, which will enable you access over there. And I believe this boss is actually optional till way later in the game. Like, you don't have to come down here and kill him, but he's pretty easy. And watch, now that I've said he's easy, I might die. Well, I don't think, I've never died on the last try, I don't think, but it grants you the soldier's key so that you can get this life ring, which we will be getting. Oh, dude, we haven't done Pate's little thing yet.
Which, no, but all you get is a soapstone, which means I'm not doing summons.
Yeah, we're gonna try to do a no summons run on this one, and I think our last run that we did no summons, but we're gonna try to do no summons this time as well, so we'll see how that goes. I just kind of wanted to do it, especially if you're if you like doing magic, you get that, you know, that hidden door that you can do. Yeah, you get the, there's a secret door that you can get a staff, which is pretty cool. And I'm not good at talking and fighting at the same time, and kind of taking a couple shots that I shouldn't have taken. And my endurance is extremely down right here. I just killed the last giant. This guy should be coming through the fog right here. There we go. He just got a couple shots on me. But as you can see, we got the soul of the last giant. Got us about 10,000 souls. And the soldier's key. Now, if you've done kind of the first quest for Pate, you can also summon him for this fight. Just keep that in mind. Even though I've already fought the last giant and beat him. I think I'd summon them for the first one, my very first playthrough, and then for our 100% playthrough I did as well. Real quick, I think there's an item over here that I may have missed, and there's definitely items over there, out that door that I missed. Remember where you can go out on the ledge and it's super risky? Remember they drop down behind you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, so there's a couple items over there. But, I forgot about the... soldier's key. We can use that. Have you done that yet?
No.
Use the soldier's key and get the life ring?
I've not yet.
I'll do that, and then we can wrap this video up and do Pursuer... Ooh, I don't want to die here. Freak, I don't want to die here. Alright, let me draw these guys out. Go ahead and get this box as well. Yeah, we can do Pursuer next time, or... Do we even need the flame sword if we have enough souls to upgrade our rapier?
Are you doing rapier as well?
You're doing rapier?
I am, yeah.
Alright, sweet. I don't even think we need the flame sword, but we can get it anyway if you want to. Have you died yet?
No.
Dude, I just got so close to dying, literally. I think that's our first ring, yep. Ring of Restoration, sweet. I thought it was the life ring, but that gradually restores HP. And I think I might have said earlier in the video that if you buy the Pharaoh's Lockstone I don't think maybe I didn't say that. The Chlorinthy ring? Did I mention that? Or was that me and you talking?
Yeah, no, you go to... You get the mansion key and you get a Pharaoh's Lockstone. You can go down there and get the...
Yeah, that's what we're going to do. And I've bought the Pharaoh's Lockstone before and used it, but you can get a free one from the mansion, which we'll do that in next episode because Pursuer shouldn't take that long to do. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
All right, guys. That's it for this episode. It may be a little bit long, but... We'll edit it down and try to get it a good length for you guys. And we will be finding the pursuer next episode. So super exciting stuff. If you guys enjoyed it, please hit the like button. And we'll catch you guys next time. Peace.
Peace.